The year 2019 has been filled with innovations in the world of automobiles in India. We saw a huge shift towards the priorities that people have when buying an automobile. Now, the buyer wants looks, build quality, capabilities, and more importantly, safety. As a result, we saw a ton of launches taking place from almost every major automaker in the country, and it ended up making 2019 a year to remember. Now, as the year comes to an end, it is time to look back and pick the best from the rest. Let's start with the top 5 hatchbacks of the year. Now, this particular segment is one of the most sought after categories in the Indian market simply because of the importance that they hold due to the huge sales number that this category racks up for manufacturers. As a result, several automakers came out with their offerings for the segment, and we have selected the best. Starting with one of the most popular names in the country, the Wagoneer, which has now come back in an all-new avatar, and this time around, it offers more space, new engine options, and also the latest range of Maruti Suzuki features. But the company did not stop there, as they also launched another hatchback in the form of the all-new Maruti Suzuki Espresso, which is the entry-level SUV offering from the company. The Espresso offers SUV-inspired styling and has a tall boy stance as well to give it a distinctive look as compared to the other offerings in this segment. That's not it, as it also offers great build quality, taking it a notch above. Then there's the Hyundai Grand i10 Nios, which pretty much lives up to its name. The word Nios means more, and the new Grand i10 Nios offers exactly that. More space, more comfort, more mileage, and a design that makes it stand out of the crowd. Speaking of which, to stand out, Ford gave their Figo hatchback a facelift and even a dash of blue. It now looks better, but more importantly, does not compromise on the thing that it has always been known for, which is its driving capabilities. And lastly, there is the Toyota Glanza, which takes the very popular and successful Baleno from the house of Maruti Suzuki and offers it from Toyota as well. All we have to say is the more the merrier. Let's move on to the list that made the most amount of noise this year, the top 5 SUV MPVs of the year. It won't be wrong to say that the Indian market is moving, if not already there yet, towards a prominent SUV culture. As a result, we have seen SUVs and MPVs of all shapes and sizes this year, and the top ones not only offered the tried and tested formula of a typical SUV that everyone loves, but also offered that little bit extra that makes them a cut above the others. One such launch was the MG Hector. Now, this one was a very important product for MG, as it was their entry into the Indian market, and for that, they pulled out all the stops with this one. The Hector is one of the most spacious offerings in its segment and brings along with itself a bold styling and host of features. But speaking of bold, there was another car with a similar story, the Kia Seltos. They too filled the car to the brim with features and on top of that, launched the car in a lot of variants to choose from as well. And all of them offered a great driving experience and the car has been a runaway success, making Kia one of the leading automakers in India right now. But SUVs these days are not all about being big and brawny, and a great example of that has been the Hyundai Venue, which took the compact SUV segment by storm. It gets modern design language and was India's first connected car, offering features unlike any other, even segments above at the time of its launch. And while SUVs were the talk of the town, the MPV segment offered a couple of surprises, and how, with people buying them in huge numbers, showed that they are in the fight too. Starting with the Renault Triber, which has been a runaway success thanks to its clever engineering and a bold design. The Triber offers a unique seating arrangement and is a great value for money car for those who put practicality and interior space at the top of their priority. But if premiumness is what you were looking for in a budget, then there was hardly anyone who could match what the Maruti Suzuki XL6 brought to the table. A part of Maruti Suzuki's Nexa lineup, the XL6 is your key to a premium MPV experience in a budget. And of course, now is the time to talk about some exciting scooters and motorcycles as part of our top 5 two-wheelers of the year list. The Soul scooter making its way to our list, holding the fort for innovation and success when it comes to scooters, is none other than the king of scooters, the Honda Activa, which bagged the title of being India's first BS6 scooter. In terms of motorcycles, we saw a lot of innovation and new products across categories and body styles. One such example was the Hero XPulse 200, which right away claimed the title for being the most accessible adventure tourer in India. And before you may think otherwise, the XPulse does not compromise on off-roading and touring capabilities in almost any way, making it an unbelievable adventure companion. But on the other end of the spectrum, we have the Suzuki Gixxer SF250, which is Suzuki Motorcycle's first quarter-liter offering, as well as a bigger sibling to the Gixxer SF150. Meant for sporty riders, this one can take on corners and long-distance touring with equal prowess, making it a definitive sports tourer. But if you want an entry-level motorcycle that does not compromise in terms of performance whatsoever, then Yamaha had the answer for you in the form of the MT-15, which is one of the sportiest and most accessible motorcycles in the country. And lastly, completing our list is the Royal Enfield Interceptor 650, which is the biggest Royal Enfield on sale right now. Despite the bump in engine displacement, it still manages to undercut every middleweight motorcycle in India. A case of many firsts for Royal Enfield, the Interceptor 650 makes for an ideal motorcycle for a vast number of riding conditions. And lastly, we have to talk about the very first part of an automobile that makes up for your first impression: design. This year, as part of our list of the top designs of the year, there were just so many options to consider. But having chosen the best ones, we start with the SUV that got everyone across the country talking about it, the Tata Harrier. If there was a book of tricks that could make an SUV look bold, well, the Harrier has pretty much used all of them and has become one of the prettiest SUVs on sale in India right now. And when it comes to sedans, we saw the return of the legendary Honda Civic, and boy is it a stunner. Clean lines, a bold stance and sporty roofline make the Civic well worthy of carrying that name. But it is not the only sedan in our list, as the Mercedes-Benz CLS showed the world how one should design a premium sedan. It sports the latest face of Mercedes-Benz and has minimal lines, making it look upmarket and modern. But the beauty lies in CLS still looking aggressive without even trying hard. But why should cars have all the fun? Because there were so many jaw-dropping, painstakingly beautiful motorcycles that came to India this year. Them was the Indian FTR 1200, which is made by Indian Motorcycles. Yes, we know you were expecting it to be a cruiser, but Indian Motorcycle has broken that stereotype, and how. And lastly, wrapping up our list is the devil itself, Ducati Diavel 1260S. If the devil ever incarnated as a biker, this is what he would ride. Is it a cruiser? Is it a sports bike? Well, it's a bit of everything. Tripping Italian beauty, the Diavel 1260S is a definite head turner.